Hello, skeletons. It's Disney Queen Skelly here, and welcome back to another Chatting Skeletons episode. So this episode is titled The Complete Story of My Sciatica. Those of you who had watched my I Have Some News videos kind of have a brief idea of what's going on, but I feel like I should fully explain my sciatica story. So this started all the way back in March when I started my training for work. I had gotten there way too early because previously we had gotten our uniforms, when we were doing, another part of training for our jobs, and we unfortunately couldn't try them on because we were already running late. So I picked out what I thought my size was, and turns out I got a size too small for my pants, so I had to go back and get another pair of pants, which hubby thankfully helped me out with. And I was there way too early. I had like 3 hours to kill. So I sat down in a chair for 3 hours eating and watching Hulu until my shift started. Now, I was sitting on a very hard chair. And after I had gotten up out of that chair, I was a little sore, which I thought was just because I had sat in the chair too long. Whatever. Didn't think much of it. Thought it'd be gone by the next day. Next day comes around. I am in searing pain. I can't move. I can't get out of bed. It feels like someone is just crushing my bones from the inside. And I'm thinking, shit, what the hell just happened? So thankfully, hubby was home and I flagged him. Now I'm like, hubby, I can't get up. I can't move. I need your help, please. So he's like, okay. So hubby starts taking care of me and I take some Advil to try and relieve the pain a little bit. It had been a week, and then my pain finally went away. I felt nothing for about 3 days, and then it came back again, and I said, if this pain does not go away by next week, I'm going to go see a doctor. Week later, I'm still in pain, and it's still a solid 10. I can't get out of bed. I can't bend down. I can't do shit. I'm thinking I had broken something or sprained something, what have you. So I go to the doctor, and of course, I didn't make an appointment, so I had to go to the urgent care where no appointment is really needed. I get seated to see a doctor, and the doctor, you know how doctors kind of like feel around your guts and shit just to make sure that, you know, nothing's out of the ordinary? Well, this doctor is pretty much pushing into my immune system, rearranging my organs, and it hurt like hell, especially when he tried to check for gallstones, which thankfully I didn't have any gallstones, or else we would have had an entirely different problem. So he's pushing around my uterus area. And for those of you who don't necessarily like medical stories or who feel a little squeamish, you don't have to watch this Chatting Skeletons episode. You can just move on to other videos if you'd like. But anyway, so he starts feeling around my uterus and he asks me where I feel the most pain. And it's actually on my left side, even though I'm feeling it more on my right. And he goes, that's kind of weird. I'm like, well, isn't there something called pain displacement? And he goes, yeah, something like that. Gives me this shit-eating grin, and he says, have you ever heard of ovarian cysts? I said, no, I've never had them. And this guy's shit-eating grin gets bigger. I said, what? Do I have them? He goes, maybe, but you need to get a vaginal x-ray just to be sure. And I said, what the fuck is a vaginal x-ray? They said, well, I'm not an expert. I don't know how it is, but I know they just stick an ultrasound camera up your vagina, and they start looking through. And I'm like, oh, my God. So I'm waiting to see if this, you know, x-ray person, this ultrasound person is ready for me, but she was booked solid until the week after, so I made an appointment. But they had me take a pelvic x-ray just to make sure that nothing, I didn't break anything in my pelvis. Sure as shit, I didn't, so that was great. So a week later, I go to get this vaginal ultrasound done, and thank God I had hubby with me or else I would have not been able to get through it. So she does an outer ultrasound first, and she can't see anything, but of course, the outside only does so much. So she pulled out what she calls the monster, and she starts fishing around, and this thing doesn't bend, so it feels super weird having it in there. And when she pulled it out, I swear to God, it felt like half my organs came out with it. She pulls it out, and she says, I'll call you with your results next week. I said, sounds great. A week passes, I don't hear shit. So I gave it a few more days, and I still don't hear anything. So I called that Monday, and I said, hey, my name is so-and-so. I had an appointment last week for a vaginal ultrasound, and I was told my results, or I had an appointment 2 weeks ago. I was told my results would be in last week, but I never got the phone call. She said, well, what's your name again? I said, this. She goes, well, I don't have your results here, but what was the name of the person who did your ultrasound? I'm like, shit, I don't remember. And she goes, well, what day did you have it done? I said, this day at this time. She goes, oh, well, this person was working that day, so let me go call her up. I said, okay. So I waited, and I figured if they didn't call them the next day, I'd call them the next day and figure out what the hell's going on. So a few hours later, I get a phone call from the same lady who I had spoken to, and she said, hi, is this so-and-so? And I said, yes, it is. And she said, well, I have the results here of your vaginal ultrasound that came back negative. I said, so I don't have ovarian cysts. She goes, no. I said, well, that's great, but now we have another problem. She goes, well, what's the problem? I said, I don't know what's going on with me. So she said, well, do you want to make an appointment with your primary care physician? I said, yeah, that'd be fantastic. So I made an appointment with my primary care physician, and I had ibuprofen that was prescribed to me at this time, and it was not over-the-counter stuff. It was, like, the good, strong stuff. I had been taking that for a few weeks, and I went to go see my primary care physician. And I had told him what was going on, and he said, well, to me, it sounds like something called sciatica. I said, well, what's sciatica? He goes, well, can you show me where you're feeling the pain? Like, yeah, it goes from my tailbone to about my left hip and a little bit down my leg. He goes, well, how far down your leg does it go? I'm like, maybe mid-thigh. He goes, yeah, that's definitely sciatica. And I said, what's sciatica? He goes, it's when you pinch your sciatic nerve and you start feeling this pain. I said, okay, well, what do you recommend? He goes, well, usually the normal course of treatment is physical therapy, but there's no actual cure for sciatica. I said, well, freaking fantastic. So I'm stuck with this thing forever. So I come home after making an appointment with a physical therapy place. And I tell my parents what had happened. And my dad said, well, you know who sciatica is common for, right? I said, no. He goes, it's usually common in pregnant women and people who are overweight. And after a long discussion, I went back to my room and I kind of sat down and I was thinking, this is a huge wake-up call. I'm 144 pounds, which is way too heavy for my height. And I now have sciatica because of my weight. And that's actually what drove me to start working out with hubby, which has actually been going very, very well. Our eating habits are actually not as good as they should be, but I'm hoping they get better. We track our weight every Saturday, and I'm hoping to get back to 110, hopefully by next year, if not by the end of the year. So we'll see what happens. But anyways, that is the complete story of my sciatica. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, little skeletons. Stay safe. Love you guys.